Do you feel like sometimes you're just drowning in metrics and reports? There is a way out of that. You can take reports that are just way too much information and you can get something pretty simple. It's simple to do when you're using a platform called Google Data Studio, and that's exactly what we're gonna be talking about in this video. I know you might be thinking, well, I already use dashboards. I've got reports. I've got too many reports. Okay, you probably do have a lot of reports, but do you really have reports that are leading to action? Or do you have reports that are just full of information? Maybe you've got dashboards, but in reality, those dashboards are just prettier looking reports. There is no story there. When it comes to dashboards, here's what I want you to think about. I want you to think about your car dashboard. When you look at your speedometer, you instantly know, do I hit the gas or do I hit the brake? You don't have to analyze it. You don't have to think about it. You don't have to review it with committee to figure out what your next steps are. You just know. Your marketing dashboards can be that simple to use when you have a platform that allows you to build them that way. And that, fortunately, is what Google Data Studio does. And be sure to stick around to the end of the video because I'm gonna show you how in a single click, you can actually create an entire Google Analytics dashboard. Just go to datastudio.google.com. Make sure that you sign in with the same Google account that you use for Google Analytics. And I want to quickly show you what's possible with Google Data Studio. The templates is a great way to see that. Here, I'm going to show you an example of an existing Google Analytics report that you could use. You can make a copy of this and then you can connect it into your own analytics. You can do the same thing with Search Console. You can copy this particular dashboard, then you connect in your YouTube account and get your own customized YouTube dashboard. I like templates, but I use templates for inspiration only, because templates were created to answer somebody else's business questions, not necessarily mine. We basically create our dashboards from scratch to answer the questions that we have that help us grow our business. Let's take a look at some of those. So the first one we have pulled up here is a product summary. So as a business owner, I need to understand very, very quickly which products are selling and which products are not, and if the trends are good or bad. That's all I care about. I don't need to see a million different details. I just want to see the things that I need to see so I can get into the report, so I can get out of the report and go start hitting the brake or hitting the gas. So in this example, you see here, we have the different Academy product, the monthly pass product, the win courses that we have, the amount of page views that those products have seen, the conversion that's happening between those products, the actual conversion rate, and the revenue that was generated from those products. So we see all these different details in a very quick, easy to read report. So let's say, for example, the Win Monthly Pass program wasn't performing as expected. I would need to know more details around that. So we have this report that shows us what the current sales rate is for this particular date range, and then goes into results and how. We have to know what our results are, but almost as importantly, we have to know how we got there. So you can see here, this quick little customer journey template shows us how many people are seeing the offer page. Of those, how many people are going to the next step, which in this case is the cart page. From there, how many convert to an actual purchase? Now, what's nice about this report is it's been designed to give me the conversion rate, so I can very quickly see if each step is converting at the rate that I expect it to convert. You can see here, I actually have a goal for each step. So I have a forecast of how I believe this should be working. And now I'm measuring against that forecast so I know if this particular customer journey is working as it was intended to work. And I can see that very quickly, not just because of the numbers, but because of the colors. But you can actually change the colors based on results. So you see here, the result is yellow because it's kind of in range, but not perfect. I've got this result, which is in red because it's way too high. And I've got this result that's green because it's just right. So where do I focus my efforts? If I focus here on this dashboard, I can very quickly see we've got an issue with the cart abandonment. I need to go look at that particular step and figure out what that might be happening. So that's where I take the conversation to my marketing team to improve that step. Then we see it in the dashboard, whether or not we're actually getting it right, because we can measure against it. So I'm not spending hours in a report trying to figure out what the heck it all means. I instantly know what it means because of how we've developed this report. And we only could do that because we're using Google Data Studio. So let's talk about how you can actually create your first Data Studio dashboard. Now, your first step is, once you come into Google Data Studio, is to click where it says blank report. This creates a blank dashboard for you. But the first thing it needs to know is, where does it get its data from? Google Data Studio, while it presents all these nice dashboards and reports that you can use, it's not actually storing any data. It has to get that data from someplace else. So in this case, we're gonna say, well, I have all the data in Google Analytics, so I want you to go to Google Analytics as the data source. We just click where it says Google Analytics, and then we tell it which Google Analytics account are we actually going to get our information from, and we click Add. And at that point, all this information is coming into Google Data Studio, and Google Data Studio creates a quick little table for us to let us know, yep, it's working, here's the information that I currently see. And from here, I can then start adding additional charts and additional tools in here. Go to where it says Add Chart. You can see all the different shapes and sizes that are coming through here. If I want to see things like user count or numbers, I would use something called a scorecard that just shows up there, and so on. And there's really two sides of the coin in every dashboard. There's the number part, where you're actually setting up the chart and everything else and getting your numbers to show. And then there's the style part. So you'll notice that when we click, in this case, on the scorecard, it says data. Well, that's kind of where it's getting its data from. But then right next to that is the style. This is where you change the colors. Here's where you can put in that conditional formatting. You can change the font, background colors, anything else to give it your look. It does take a little bit of work and effort to make sure you've got a properly functioning dashboard. But as a pro tip, I'll tell you, the more you put into planning and asking what questions are we trying to answer and what actions are we going to take based on those answers, the better your dashboards are going to be. So make sure you're always trying to tie things down to action. I want to show you a very fast, the fastest way I've ever found to create a fully functional Google Data Studio dashboard report that's based on your own Google Analytics, and you can do it with the click of a mouse. So we're going to click back into Google Analytics. And in your Google Analytics, if you come into your customization section, just click where it says custom reports, and you'll see this message right here at the top of your custom report section. Now, if for some reason you don't see this exact message in this exact spot, just take a few seconds to look around. It's probably something that's very similar to it there. All we need to do is click, do I want to learn more about my audiences, my acquisitions, which is where the traffic is coming from, or the behaviors, which are the actions that my users are taking. Let's click on where it says audiences in our case, and instantly you see Google Data Studio opens up. It automatically connects the dots to your Google Analytics. You don't have to define a data source anymore. It automatically creates all these charts, and it fills these charts with your data from your Google Analytics account. Now, how do I actually do anything with this? Well, I've got a little view only that I can play with here. But if you click on what says edit and share, it'll instantly bring you into the section of Google Data Studio. All that comes in, and now you can adjust it accordingly. And this is a really good pro tip, because this helps me get a lot of the things that maybe I want to know, but some of the stuff maybe I don't want to know. So if I don't care about new visitors or returning visitors, I can just delete that out. And if I did want to, you know, have something else there, I can add a new chart and customize it accordingly. So this is a really great way to shortcut a lot of steps, but it is a good idea to use it for inspiration, pull in this report, and then customize it to your liking, so that you can get answers to the questions that you're asking. One more place to find really incredible ideas for inspiration when it comes to dashboards is the Data Studio Gallery. You'll see a list of all of these different dashboards, some that are featured, some that are available from the community, and you can see what other people are measuring, how they're measuring it. It's a really great place to get inspiration when it comes to dashboards. Building a Data Studio report is a completely different matter. Click here to actually learn how to do that step by step, or click here to continue your journey here at Social Media Examiner as we continue learning about measurement. Either way, I'll see you on the next video.